الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the world, the merciful, the master of the day of judgment. I bear witness there is no God but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his messenger and his slave. My dear brother and sister in Islam, I advise myself first and I advise all of you to practice the fear in the deepest of your heart and practice it in your daily life. My dear brother and sister in Islam, there is one question, which is how you connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How you can make communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through the prayer, you are able to connect with your Lord. With prayer, with salat, you are able to connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The word in Arabic, which means salat, the real meaning in English is connect, is communication. The real meaning of salat in Arabic is mean communication and connect. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned that when any one of you stand to practice his prayer, he is connect with his Lord. So do not interrupt him and do not act and cut his communication with his Lord, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is hadith in Al-Bukhari and Muslim. narrated by Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala an, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that I divide the prayer between me and my slave to two sections. So when my slave said that Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, when my slave said Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, my slave thanks and praise me. And when he said Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Allah said, my slave is glorified me. Then when he said Maliki Yawm al-Din, Allah says, my slave is glorified me. And when he said Iyyaka na'budu wa Iyyaka nasta'in, Allah says, this is between me and my slave. And whatever my slave asks, he will receive. And whatever my slave he asks, he will receive. You can imagine, my brother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala connect with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responds you during your prayer. When you say Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is responds you. When you said Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is response you. And when you say Maliki Yawm al-Din, also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is response you. My dear brother and sister in Islam, the prayer is the one of the most important thing in Islam. That's why the prayer is the second prayer of Islam. And as you know, we fast 1 month a year. And we make zakat one time a year. And we make hajj one time the entire of your life. However, we pray 5 times a day. We pray at least five times a day. The question is why? Because you need to connect with your Lord. You need to connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are weak with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are nothing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot be satisfied. You cannot be happy if you do not connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at least 5 times a day. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this is mandatory to pray and conduct and make communication with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala 5 times a day. My dear brother and sister in Islam, Allah makes salat mandatory in majestic and great circumstances. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is example, for instance, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the salat mandatory for Musa, peace be upon him, nation, Allah talked directly to Musa. Allah talked directly to Musa alayhi salam to make the salat mandatory, to make the salat obligatory. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the prayer is mandatory for our ummah, he talked to our Prophet, peace be upon him, directly during the ascension to heaven. You can imagine, my brother and sister in Islam, how the prayer is important in our life. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all the mandatories between Allah and Jibreel and our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, except the prayer, directly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the heaven, not even in the earth on the ground, just from Allah to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is the sign why prayer is important for us. Allah mentioned in the Holy Quran, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ مَا وَصْفُهُمْ مانعتهم الذين هم في صلاتهم خاشعون. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, the translation of this ayah, Allah mentioned the describe of real mu'min who practice and may concentrate in his during his pray on time. This is the real mu'min. There is one man came to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then ask our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the worthy deed he should do. Then our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responds him. He said, pray on time. This is the worthy deed you should do. Then he asked our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again. Then the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, responds him again, pray on time. This is the worthy deed you should do. Then even for third time, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, pray on time. Then the fourth time, he asked same question. Then the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responds him, al-jihad in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can imagine that. A prayer is better than al-jihadu fi sabilillah. When you're able to make your life, is easy to spend for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake. For the jihad, the fighting to in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is the prayer the most important, even the jihad? My brother and sister in Islam, our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that, narrated by Abu Huraira, إِنَّ أَوَّلْ مَا يُحَاسَبُ عَلَيْهِ الْعَبْدُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ الصَّلَاةِ فَإِنْ صَلَحَتْ فَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ وَأَنْجَحْ وَإِنْ فَسَدَتْ فَقَدْ خَابَ وَخَسِرْ. That translation is that the first matter the slave will be brought to account in the day of judgment is a prayer. So if it is sound and it is good, that all his deed will be sound and good. However, if a prayer is bad, the rest of his deed will be bad. The main thing is a prayer. If your prayer is sound in the day of judgment, all your deed will be fine. However, if your prayer is bad, that means all your deed will be bad. Because if you do not practice your prayer, maybe you consider as non-Muslim. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said that, مَا سَلَكَكُمْ فِي سَقَرْ قَالُوا لَمْ نَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُصَلِّينَ. That translation is that those people who in hellfire, their conversation is that they ask each other, why you are in hellfire? Then they response them, because we weren't one of those that practice prayer on time. This is the reason why those people in hellfire, because they are, do not practice and offer and perform prayer on time. So they affect to be in the hellfire. Also, if you are practice prayer on time, that will protect you from all prohibited. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned that, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. If you pray on time, your prayer will help you to leave and keep away from the any kind of prohibited. That's why Allah, the first point and the first deed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will account in the day of judgment is prayer. If it is sound and good, this is good news for you. All your deed will be sound and good. However, if it is bad, that means all your deed will be bad. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in Sahih Muslim, إِنَّ الْعَهْدَ الَّذِي بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَهُمُ الصَّلَاةِ فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرْ. The translation is that the main differences between Muslim and non-Muslim is prayer. And anyone who disregard this prayer, he will consider as non-Muslim. This hadith in Sahih Muslim. And there is one ayah, I believe this ayah is one of we have, I mean, to listen to this ayah from the deepest of our heart. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, Mr. Rajim, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَى وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى قَالَ رَبِّ لِمَ حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَقَدْ كُنْتُ بَصِيرًا قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا فَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. That translation is that. And whoever turn away from my remembers, indeed, he will face the hardship. Excuse me, please be quiet. And however, who turn away from my remembers, he will face the hardship of life. And he will face the worst things in his life. And in the day of judgment, he will rise as a plant. Then he will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, "My Lord, I used to be seeing, but why now I'm plant?" Then Allah responds him, "Because my ayah and my sign came to you, but you ignore that and disregard that. So you will forget today. If you forget Allah ayah in dunya, Allah will forget you in the day of judgment." My dear brother, you have a chance now. Those people who are in the grave right now, they just need one moment to come to the life and remember Allah and go back to their grave. You have a chance, my dear brother and sister in Islam. If you forget Allah in the dunya, Allah will forget you in the day of judgment. Even in the life, Allah will give you the hardship of the life and the worst of the life. Even in the hereafter, in the day of judgment, you will face like this because you ignore the ayah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody around the world will make the sin, no doubt, without doubt. But prayer is the most important thing in Islam for your life. No excuse to leave and ignore and disregard prayer. If you are traveling, Allah make it easy for you. You can imagine to pray in one time and pray two rak'ah instead of four rak'ah. If you are unwell and you cannot stand up to pray, okay, pray while you are sitting. If you cannot sitting, while you are lying. If you cannot make pollution by water, so you can make it by sand. Allah make it easy for you. No excuse for you to leave this prayer. So we have to practice our prayer in our life. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned that بشر المشائين في الظلم إلى المساجد بالنور التام يوم القيامة. That translation is that tell my ummah good news. بشر in Arabic is mean good news. Tell them good news. Those people who walk to the masjid in the dark, tell them they will receive the completely brightness in the day of judgment. My dear brother and sister in Islam, anyone of us who doesn't want to reach completely bright in the day of judgment, absolutely without doubt, all of us want to have the completely brightness in the day of judgment. So when you are walking to the masjid in the dark, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your result will be rich, the brightness in the day of judgment. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me and all of you. Please ask Allah whatever you want. Alhamdulillah ala ihsani wa shukru lahu ala tawfiqihi wa imtinani. My dear brother and sister in Islam, what kind of excuse do you have for your Lord? What kind of excuse you will provide for your Lord, who bless you by 24 hours? Who bless you by 24 hours a day? Do you have to excuse that you haven't 30 minutes to practice prayer? Allah bless you by 24 hours. So, do you have 30 minutes to practice the prayer? Without doubt, absolutely yes. Even you are busy, you have to stop and pray. Even you are traveling, you have to stop on the time and pray. Just 30 minutes. It will affect your life. You will be satisfied. You will be happy in the life. And in the day of judgment, in the hereafter, inshallah, you will be in the paradise. Just make attention. Be attention. Pray is the easiest thing you have to do in your life, because it is kind of exercise. And exercise for your heart when you make attention and to pray exactly as our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam done. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said that أرأيتم لو أن نهرا بباب أحدكم يغتسل فيه هل يبقى من درنه شيء؟ قالوا لا يا رسول الله. قال فذلكم الصلوات الخمس يمحو الله بها الخطايا. The translation is that our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said that narrated by Abu Hurairah in Sahih al-Bukhari. If there is river outside your door and you make bath and wash 5 times a day, is there any kind of dirty will still in your body? The companion answered, no, my Prophet, no, my beloved. Then Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam said that this is the example of a prayer. When you pray, know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remove your sins. And you can imagine that why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam make the dirty of body like sins. Because the sins is like the dirty of your body. Because it affects your heart. And the dirty affects your body. So there is, when you have sins and you have a black point in your heart, is like a black point in your body. You have to clean up your heart by pray 5 times a day. My dear brother and sister, when you raise your hand to start your prayer, what the word you said? You said, Allahu Akbar. What is the meaning of Allahu Akbar? The main meaning of Allahu Akbar is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, is the greatest thing around the world. No one, no your job, no your business, no your even your bad or your problem or anything is greater than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah will resolve and fix your problem. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is greater than your problem. Don't worry, Allah will fix that. If you really believe that, Allah is greater than your problem. This is the meaning when you start your prayer by Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar is mean, Allah is the greatest. Allah is greater than everything. Allah is greater than your problem. Allah is greater your job. So leave your job and go to Allah. And when you raise your hand to say Allahu Akbar, this is the wisdom behind that is you leave the dunya behind you and start to connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You leave the dunya when you start to raise your hand when you say Allahu Akbar. Sign of leave the dunya behind you and connect with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even when you make sujood and put your face and the head over in the sand, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you from the sand and you go to the sand. And you will go in the grave to the sand. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the sand. It is kind of humble. So see Allah to my weakness. Oh my Allah, oh my Lord, see to my weakness how I need your help. How I need you stand with me. Oh my Allah, I make sujood and I make it so humble. Just in the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the main thing of sujood. My brother and sister in Islam. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will identify you in the day of judgment by one thing. Simahum fi wujuhim min athar sujood. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will identify his ummah, his nation by their face when they're making sujood. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يغفر لنا ويرحمنا. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعيننا على أداء الصلاة. I ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to bless us to practice and offer prayer on time. I ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to accept our prayer. I ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to bless all of you in paradise in the day of judgment. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless our parents. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless all of us with satisfied life and happy life. And ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as he make us together in this masjid, ask Allah to make us together in the day of judgment, in the paradise with our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.
My dear brethren, sister, assalamu alaikum. I have a couple of announcements very important. MashaAllah, we are in ninth year serving the community through Masjid Ibn-e-Maryam and through Tarbiyah School. And now Masjid is expanding. It started with 3 people, 4 people, 8, 9 years ago. And now we are running out of space in this Masjid. We have a plan to expand that one. But at the same time, we are trying to accommodate through our brothers who come late using their lunchtime from their job. And this is our duty to accommodate them. That's why, inshallah, we are going. We will finish by 2:35, 2:40. First Juma will start strictly 1:10, 1:15, and we will finish that 1:45. Inshallah, whoever is comfortable to attend second Juma, you are very welcome, inshallah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is a sign of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, barakah, health, sakina. When you are busy with the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the sakina come and you should feel that. MashaAllah, today Khutbah brother Michel, MashaAllah, Allahu Akbar, MashaAllah, let you jazai khair. We enjoy this very much. And second request is, every Juma, I believe we have at least 200 people, including the sister on the other side. And each of you, if give us $5, that will bring us $1,000 a week, which will be helpful to pay the salary of the imam and other expenditure, the electric bill, water bill. You know, you've been going through this one. It is very disappointing that people don't want to busy with the business with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I swear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah has given me taqwa based on that. If you spend your money pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will not decrease. That's when I count, I excite every day, maybe every week, maybe I get this week 500, 600. But please think about that during the business. Money, to give you more money, think about it this way. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you jazai khair. Whoever is participating in the contribution, Allah accept that and Allah give you more and more and more. And Allah help to accept your du'as, and Allah help you, your family, your loved one, and whatever need you have, Allah fulfill your need. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum. So remember, next Friday,
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استووا please fill the gap استووا الله أكبر
الله
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون. نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون. نزلا من غفور رحيم. ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين. ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم. وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا ذو حظ عظيم. وإما ينزغنك من الشيطان نزغ فاستعذ بالله إنه هو السميع العليم.
الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده. ربنا الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب.
الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله
أكبر. الله أكبر.
الله.
الله أكبر.
الله.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
I forget one thing to mention. The second Juma khutbah will be by Sheikh Imam Tariq in Arabic. If some people want to join Arabic khutbah, please come. Inshallah.